everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time to continue our challenge runs here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Rebirth series. Thank you everyone who's been showing support for the challenge runs. I think I should have had a win last time. Got kind of rough in the womb. What can you do about it? We're going to be moving on to the No Soul Hearts Challenge, which basically means I am not allowed to acquire Soul Hearts via items or pickups. Now, I will say that if I accidentally pick up a Soul Heart that's on the ground, I will lose it immediately. I'll just find a way to damage myself. That's not really that much of a hassle. But that includes me picking up... I'm not allowed to pick up items that grant me Soul Hearts. For example, Ceremonial Robes. Evil Hearts are included, by the way. Ceremonial Robes, picking up Soul Hearts off the ground, the Rosary, Abaddon, yeah, all those, all that sort of stuff. So I will not be able to take any Soul Hearts. And I should also mention that the other requirement on this challenge is that if there is a Curse of the Blind, I am allowed to call for only one floor. I'm allowed to say, hey, I'm going to be taking the items on this because since I don't know what they are, they might give me Soul Hearts, and that's not my fault. So I'm absolved of that sin. But for the most part, this is going to be kind of challenging. So here's your seat today. It's going to be Lima Hotel 4 Alpha, Echo November Romeo 0. I am allowed to pick up anything else, so I'm hoping that we don't get too many Curses of the Blinds here. Ideally, I would love to take Black Candle, however, it gives you a Soul Heart, and you're not allowed to do that. See how that works? So I'm stuck with it, man, I really am. We should have had a win on that last challenge, we got kind of hosed there. But, of course, keep in mind these are challenge runs, so we're putting an unusual amount of strain on our runs. Thanks to our crazy constraints of not taking any items except for ones that appear in item rooms only. It's pretty tough. We got lucky, too, with Magic Mush, but still, it wasn't enough. I have been getting some questions from people asking me, well, how are you going to do the ultimate challenge run? How are you going to do the ultimate challenge run if you can only, the example that was brought up was if you can only take deals with the angel items, but you can also only take items that appear in item rooms. How are you going to do that? That's some smart damage right there, by the way. And the answer to that is that there's going to be some compromises. For that particular instance, and I'm only going to divulge what I'm thinking about doing for that particular instance, is we'll say something like, I'm allowed to take, let's say, two deal with the angel items, period. But that's it. And they also cannot grant me Soul Hearts. Sort of thing. You see how that works? It's gonna be. I'm gonna have to make like a list. I'm gonna have to type up a list of all the challenges that we've done, and then decide how are they going to synergize with each other, because it has to be somewhat winnable. I'm not saying I'm gonna win it, and most likely, you know, 99% of the chance here, I'm not going to win it. I almost screwed myself out of that bomb, but doesn't matter. I'd absolutely love to pick up those Soul Hearts. But it has to be somewhat winnable. I mean, and because we can't say, well, you can only pick up items from boss rooms, but then you can also only pick up items from item rooms, sort of thing. You know what I mean? Like, it has to be, there will be some compromises made, but still holding true to most of the integrity of a particular challenge versus another. And we've taken a lot of damage on this floor, which I'm not too happy about. So I'm looking for a win here, right? I want to get as many wins as possible before we do the ultimate challenge. I should also mention right now, that's cute. 2020 is a fantastic item. I should also mention right now that coming up this Friday and Saturday, May 1st and May 2nd, is actually my birthday. My birthday is on May 1st, and I will be doing the tradition which I started 2 years ago, which is I do a 24-hour stream for my birthday. This time's a little bit different because I don't think that I'm going to be able to stream for 24 hours straight anyway. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be going for two 12-hour streams starting on Friday, May 1st at noon, and that will... Which was, by the way, noon Central Time, so it's 1 p.m. Eastern and 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And I'll be doing that all the way up till midnight, so for 12 hours straight, I'll be streaming a bunch of games, having some fun with friends, that sort of thing. It was a lot of fun for the past 2 years, especially last year. Last year's birthday was amazing. It was by far my best birthday, and hopefully we can have some of the same vibes going up this year. And then I'm going to round off the 24-hour stream by resuming the stream on Saturday. Oh, wow, we got the Steven upgrade. That was a damage upgrade and a half. And that is also a very rare upgrade. You don't normally see Steven. You usually see little Steven, but hey, I'll take it. Especially with 2020. So, of course, anyone and everyone is more than welcome to join us for my birthday stream. I thought about maybe taking Tammy there, or Tammy's head, rather, but meh. Don't think it's going to be worthwhile this early on, unfortunately. Sun card. I'll go ahead and use that right... Well, I'm not going to use that now. Let me use it in the big room so we can kill a bunch of stuff. Sun card heals you for a full heal, gives you the map compass effect, and it deals 60 damage to everything in the room. So that will allow me to get inside the curse room if I want to. I'm not going to be taking pills, by the way, as there is a chance that it will give you the Balls of Steel upgrade. Which, admittedly, is a lot easier to drop than some of the other items. I guess I will go in here. Yeah, that was a waste of time. It's a great curse room, though. It's a fantastic curse room, just unfortunately I can't pick them up. We had so much fun last year for my birthday stream. Again, traditionally they've been 2 hours. Yeah, we'll absolutely take that. Not 2 hours, 24 hours. Traditionally, my birthday streams have been 24 hours, but this time around, I honestly don't think I can do a 24-hour stream. That's why I'm splitting it between 2 days. So either way, you are personally, this is Sinvicta's personal invitation for you all fine nerds and nerdettes to join me this Friday and Saturday, Friday, May 1st and Saturday, May 2nd. For my birthday streams, and it's not going to be anything huge or anything special. It's just we're just having fun playing video games. I might have some famous friends come by to play a game or two with me. All depends on schedules, of course, but I think it's a pretty neat way to spend my weekend. I would rather be nowhere else other than hanging out in the mosh pit with all of my fans and friends out there alike. So we got the movement speed upgrade, which I'm okay with. Still would love to get a key. Admittedly, going after the golden chest there with our one and only key, in hindsight, was not the smartest idea. But I would argue that if it worked out, it would have made me look pretty smart. But what can you do? All right, so we're not going to be... Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get into our item room, which is a little bit... It's annoying, but we also got kind of lucky in the fact that I did take Tammy's head, and we got an actual usable upgrade out of that. So I guess technically in a roundabout way, it's possible we may not have actually lost anything on that. We don't have a key, fortunately. Well, like, unfortunately... I don't know where I was going with that. So we've got a very, very good start here as far as our damage and items go. 2020 is unbelievably good. Stigmata helps a bunch, or not Stigmata, sorry, Blood of the Martyr, as well as the Steven upgrade, which is, again, one of the rarest damage upgrades in the game. Not quite as rare as Sacred Heart is, but nonetheless, it's still pretty darn rare, and I think that takes... Okay, how about we just don't die in this room? How's that sound, Isaac? Sound pretty good to you? Sounds great to me, man. So I have no idea how much health we have now, thanks to Curse the Unknown, and that is a dangerous feeling. And this room also sucks. Not get trapped here. Surprised that this Greedhead's still alive. Okay, so we did get a key. Honestly, I feel like I should go in. I should go into the shop here. We don't have any bombs. Did we get in the shop for free, or did we have two keys and I didn't realize it? I'm going to buy this Red Heart, as wasteful as that may seem. Considering I have no idea how much health we have left, and my instincts tell me that we were down to maybe one heart after that room. This is a peace of mind sort of thing. Would love to have a bomb here. These are bomb spiders, but they do not give you bombs. Again, we have sort of the widespread here with the 2020 play. Still don't have a bomb, alright. I would not feel comfortable going in there until I know for sure that I have full health. More likely than not, it's probably going to end up being... we're on the catacomb, so most likely it's going to be... I would say either one of the horsemen or... I guess it technically could be... Monstro 2? Is that who I'm trying to think of? So we got a million things going on right now on the other monitor. Mongo Baby is not too bad. I actually don't mind Mongo Baby. It's not a great item, but it's also not a bad familiar. in the grand scheme of things, especially given the fact that it does adhere to whatever other familiars you might have. So Mongo Baby, if we get a chance to get like BFF, I mean, Mongo Baby does surprisingly robust amounts of damage. We still have a bomb. I don't know why I thought I did. And it's... there is a bomb inside of the shop that I could buy and then gain access to those three other bombs in the other room there. Which might be a smart idea. We'd basically be paying 5 cents for three bombs. Which is not a bad trade at all. We got a bomb anyway, so we don't have to worry about that anymore. We're definitely not at full health because the mob trap room is not open for us. But thankfully with this bomb room over here, I will be able to heal myself back up to full along with getting the bombs. And I could also go back and get that key if I wanted to. A super secret room there, it's alright. We'll use one bomb here just to bridge the gap. Oh wow, yeah, we actually had less health than I realized. Gonna be the husk. Monstro 2, I believe, is only in cave, or not the caves, but Necropolis and Depths, I believe. Maybe. I don't know. I have a hard time remembering that. Super Bandage is fantastic, especially for what we're doing in this challenge. And yeah, I would love to take that. We've got 7 cents. You know what? Let's just go to the next floor. It would have been nice to get Nun's Habit. Alright, so we have a... oh, apparently we got also... oh, Super Bandage gives you 2 soul hearts, doesn't it? Does it? I don't remember. Well, like I said, I'm going to make restitution for taking soul hearts here, so you drop them off. I thought the Super Bandage was just 2 red hearts, but apparently it's 2 soul hearts. And 1 red heart upgrade. So we are not going to be getting any deals with the devil, that's for sure. Which, honestly, we don't really need with our damage. I think I have to take Chocolate Milk. This time around, in this late of the game, even though we're not really at late game status, but this is it's a pretty solid upgrade for where we are. Whipworm's fantastic for Chocolate Milk as well. I say we go, let's go heal back up to full just in case, then we'll fight our boss and see if we get a deal with the devil, which is almost guaranteed that we have not. I'll have to go see what's in the arcade as well. We need keys. There's an Eternal Heart, and we got keys. Okay, well, I will definitely be back for the Eternal Heart before this map is over. We got Chocolate Milk. Let's go see what's inside of the shop real quick. It is going to be greed. And that was some bad damage. And that was some more bad damage. All right. Deal with the devil is absolutely, positively not happening. I really don't know what I'm expecting here. I was hoping that maybe we would get another bomb so I wouldn't have to use the bomb to get these hearts. But at the same time, I was not expecting to take that much damage on a very simple fight. Whipworm, by the way, just massively increases the travel speed of your tears. Let me Gertie Sr. But yeah, we have absolutely no chance for Deal with the Devil here. If we get a Deal with the Devil, it's almost guaranteed to be Krampus. So, Chocolate Milk, for those of you who don't know, Chocolate Milk is a charge item, but you have to manually fire your tears as well. We got meat. Meat's fantastic. Again, we're doing no soul hearts, so the more red hearts we can get, the better. Did that work? Yeah, there we go. A little disappointed at that, gonna be honest. We should go play the arcade for... we should play the arcade for utility items at this point. We need keys, we need bombs. And I think that if we don't do that, we'd be silly. So let's go play the arcade a little bit. We've already seen the shop, already seen the item room, and to be quite honest, I don't really care about the rest of this floor. Alright, so we have to be a little bit careful here because we are rolling with nothing but red hearts. I think I'll go down to 3 hearts for now just to play it safe. Alright, so we're looking for keys and bombs. Keys and bombs here. There's a key. I'll go down to 5 cents. I really don't want to push it too much with the amount of health that we have. Okay, 4 cents. I think that there's also a heart. There's another red heart in the other room, so. There we go. There's our bombs, and this will be the last pull. Alright, well, we ended up getting some help out of that. I'm gonna save my final bomb here. I will go back and pick up this red heart. And pick up the Eternal Heart, and we're just gonna go down to the next floor. Surprisingly making pretty decent time. But we didn't pick up that Soul Heart. I'm not gonna blow it up because that's our only, literally our only bomb, and we're done. So we're still walking away with 6 cents. We have a chance to get an arcade on the next floor. We paid the greed tax, hopefully we don't have to pay it again. And we got two or three HP upgrades. I don't remember. I think it may have been 3 HP upgrades. On the last floor. So Curse of the Unknown is quite dangerous, especially, again, given our somewhat dangerous amount of, low amount of HP that we have, or lack thereof. I think we have 3 full red hearts, thanks to the Eternal Heart. I do need to be careful. I'd love to get over there, unfortunately I can't. So the longer you charge Shock and Milk, the more damage it does. The flip side to that is, of course, you have to manually fire your shots, which is kind of cumbersome. I have become cumbersome of this world. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. Alright, we traded one bomb for 2 more keys. Pretty fair trade. Now I don't really feel the need to go over there. Unless I need the full charge for anything. Money is always fun. Eventually, we'll find something to fight. Alright. And we got more bombs. Good. And so we're definitely improving on this floor. This is a big floor for us as well. Parasite's fantastic. Especially with Chocolate Milk in 2020. So that will make shots split off and deal more damage. Not sure how we didn't take a hit there. I'm glad we didn't. I'm not going to ask questions. We're up to 11 cents now. Looking pretty good, Isaac. So far, so good on the No Soul Heart Challenge. We've been getting quite fortunate with our red hearts, though. I mean, getting super bandaged into meat, into an Eternal Heart randomly from the slot machine is pretty fortunate. Maybe the game feels bad about the last challenge. I don't know. I'm not going to ask questions. I'll take it as they give it. Got the champion right away. Did not take a hit there. All right, up to 12 cents. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. Soul Converter is obviously not going to help out at all. And I don't care about the fanny pack. Don't really care about piggy bank either, to be quite honest. That's a lot of money that we just got out of that. All right, so we'll come back to that if we get another reroll. Got to be careful of the fires in here. That looks prime positioning for the Super Seeker room. We got a little bit of a revenge shot from the game there for us not taking damage in that last room. I'm just gonna machine gun these down here. So again, I have no idea how much health I have. And this red heart, where was this red heart? Right there. It seems like kind of a waste of a bomb. But again, given the fact that I have no idea how much or how little health we have, I've got to do everything I can to try to stay alive. Every instinct in my body is telling me to blow up those skulls for soul hearts. Obviously, I can't do that. I can, but then I wouldn't be truthful to the challenge. There is a reroll there, and I am enjoying that. Sun card! That is a pretty big get. So if I feel like we need to use the sun card, I will use it on the boss room. In defense of me not knowing exactly how much health we have. Need a gate. Gotta be careful because he's got... Yeah. The gate doesn't do that brimstone shot until he has two familiars out in the room. Took way too much damage to get a deal with the devil again. I'm not all that surprised. We'll just go down to the next floor. I'm not gonna re-roll the shop. Curse of the Blind. I am going to declare that I will be taking the items on this floor. So this is my one and only Curse of the Blind floor. And for some reason, I used the D6 there as well. That wasn't a very smart move there, Isaac. I'm gonna blame that one on you, Isaac. That's alright, we'll have rerolls on this floor. Got more hearts. So we're sitting at 6 HP right now. I'm really glad that we got the Sun card. Curse room is an interesting idea. I'll only go in the curse room if we have a reroll. In case there is an item pedestal in there. Parasite's just gonna make these guys fly all over the place. Another red heart. That's good. Well, since we have red hearts and I'm here, I might as well go see if there's anything in here that we care about. There's not. We could have a chance of bombing our way out of here. So, like I said, if I accidentally pick up a soul heart here via an item, I will get rid of the soul heart, but I'm not to be yelled at because I said from the very start this is my one and only time I'm allowed to take items blindly for this floor. Or for this run, rather. We'll be on this floor. Very glad that Guts decided not to swing over this way. The official name of those mobs, by the way, are actually Guts. Don't believe me? You can go check it out in the vanilla version of the Binding of Isaac. Right, so I have a reroll. Our item room's right here. This room shouldn't be that bad. Again, given our damage, we got pretty good damage. There we go. So inside of our item room, no idea what it is. Gonna be Harlequin Baby. Definitely would have rerolled that. Gotta be honest. I will use a bomb. I'm gonna use a key to get inside of the shop, though. Super greed. All right, so we know that our shop is good, which is beautiful. And I'm hoping that's the quarter. Yeah. Alright, so again, Curse of the Blind. We have no idea what it is. Portable slot. And starter deck. And that would be a Degas rune. So that gives us a purity. Or that basically makes it... ooh, Humbling Bundle. Got lucky there. We got the Fool card as well, so... Oh, but we just missed Boss Rush. That's okay. So that gives us a free pass if we do get another Curse of the Blind. Wait, did the Degas rune change to a Fool card or no, I'm an idiot. We have starter deck. Never mind. Just don't listen to me. Don't even listen to me, man. Even I don't know what I say sometimes. Humbling Bundle gives you plus one keys, plus one bombs forever, which is always awesome indeed. Lover's card. I think I might hold on to the Fool card just in case if I need to go into a curse room but need a free exit. Lover's card would be smarter as far as survivability goes. What did... Oh, it was Harlequin Baby, that's right. We didn't have anything to re-roll. You know what? I think we're just gonna go. We didn't have anything to re-roll. Actually, no. I do need to get a re-roll on the D6. We're not done yet. It would've been a little bit silly. It was Harlequin Baby in the item room, and then we got the starter deck, portable slot, and Humbling Bundle out of the shop. So that was a good deal. That was a pretty good deal. If that's the best I can do on a blind floor, then I'll take it. It certainly could have been a whole lot worse, as we all are well aware of. Got some extra bombs, pretty happy about that. Let's just go on to the next round. By round, I mean floor. So So we're in a good spot. We're in a very comfortable position with our damage. We've got enough. We have enough red hearts to win. I'd still like a little bit more just as insurance, but if this is all we've got, then this is all we've got. A little bit more movement speed would be nice. There goes our deer with the devil. Not that we really had a chance of getting one anyway. Yep. And we're just going to go down to the next floor, so I've got a purity rune that's going to allow me to purge any curse that I may come across. We have a way of teleporting out of a sticky situation. Sticking with Whipworm, thank you very much. Curse chest. No guppy items, although, again, to be fair, we don't have a chance of getting a deal with... I knew that I wasn't going to get a deal with the devil on this run, period, just because of how bad I am. I will open this since we do have Humbling Bundle. Theoretically, I could use the Fool card out of here, but I think that'd be a little bit wasteful, considering it's only going to take us maybe 30 seconds to clear this room. With our damage, Chocolate Milkman's really, really good. Not the Chocolate Milkman, but Chocolate Milkman. And we still took a hit anyway. Standard Sinvicta policy right there. Always have to take damage at the last possible second in every room. Another chest. And more keys. I'm feeling a lot better about this run than I was on the previous run at this point in time. Alright, so... Sloth here, that could be interesting. I cannot believe that he spat the silkworm out that way. That's the first time I think I've seen that happen, where the sloth spawns the silkworm in the direction that Isaac is in. Yeah, I'm not gonna be taking that. I think that would be pretty foolish to do so. Thanks for your time, big beautiful fly, but I am inclined to say no. Would have loved if we had Liberty Cap just so I could cheese where exactly our boss is. And tinted rocks don't really matter unless if I could look for the small rock, which would definitely be a big help. Not that we need the damage. We have game-ending damage right now. But, again, you can always have a little bit more. I'm surprised that Chubb even tried to go down there. And he can actually fit through that, really. That was a nightmare scenario. Seeing Chubb go through that skinny little crack there, I didn't think that he was going to be able to make it through, but apparently he can. This is why Whipworm is also so good, is because you can actually hit these guys before they decide to go down and run and hide like the little pansies they are. There we go, grab some more bombs, and hopefully, yeah, there's our boss room. Would love to get a deal with the devil item if we can. Not surprising if we don't, however. Again, without any insulation from the red heart damage that we have been getting, there's no real surprise that we're not getting deals with the devil. All right, so we got to kill Death here before getting his horse. Where were you, Death, when we were trying to get those level 4 Cuban meat transformations, man? I'm not going to take ball of bandages here. Reroll it and we get the box. What's in the box? It's going to be Curved Horn. And the Moon card. Well, as much as I love... the Whipworm, Curved Horn is just too good. Curved Horn is a... It's basically a damage up. It's just a straight up damage upgrade. And a good one at that. Alright, so we are in Utero 2. Curved Horn is definitely going to help out. There is a tinted rock in this room. See if you can spot it. I'm about to blow it up. It's right there. I'd prefer not to go into the big room if at all possible. I think I actually might... I'm just going to use the moon card here, so we can hopefully... Never mind, I was going to say, so we can hopefully maybe bypass the big room, but it's not looking like I'm going to get a chance to do that. Or maybe I will. There's two big rooms. It should be obvious that I'm holding on to the Degas rune in case if we do get a Curse of the Blind on the chest. Because that would be kind of lame to make it through 99% of the run without picking up Soul Hearts, only to accidentally get, like, say, not Abaddon, but get something that gives us a bunch of Soul Hearts in the chest. That would be pretty lame. Still looking for a way to go. There's another big room. You know what? I just don't feel like being in this room. Can you guys handle that, Polycephalus? I don't care if you can or can't. I'm out. I'd rather fight this room than that other room, that's for sure. By the way, if you haven't noticed already, Mongo Baby is imitating Harlequin Baby. Because that's what he does. He's a bro. I think Mongo Baby is a good... He's not like an overall good item, but he makes a... If he had to get a familiar, you could certainly do worse than Mongo Baby. The Chariot card is not all that great. Unfortunately, we went to the wrong direction yet again, so I'm going to use another bomb here just to not have to suffer in this terrible room. Know what, Isaac? There you go. Yep, saw that one coming. I was worried about the top heart shooting us. That's the reason why I got a little too close there. It's good to know that we have hearts just in case. And this one won't cost me a bomb, so there's that. With 6 HP, wow, man. That cheap shot. Did you see that, like, super-duper quick shot that eye did? We didn't even get a chance to move. Anyway. Forgot what I was going to say now. Oh, with 6 red hearts and this damage, I think we'll be okay. Chocolate milk is a big part of this, of what's going to end up making or breaking this run for us. And to be honest, I'm happy that I picked up chocolate milk. It's not one of my favorite items, but it's an item that quickly rose up my power rankings for, like, items in Rebirth. It's not an item that I liked in Vanilla. But with so many tier combinations that you can get now, chocolate milk, especially with the synergy you get from Sad Bombs, is amazing with Sad Bombs. Game-breaking with Sad Bombs, almost. So we're going to rattle off some big charge shots in the middle here. If at all possible, one more big charge shot should do it. Got through the Mom's Heart fight with no damage taken, and heading up to the cathedral. We're doing good. Doing good. I don't want to jinx it. I don't want to jinx it, but I feel like we're doing solid. I'm really hating this room. Every time I come to this room, I instantly am reminded why it's one of my least favorite rooms in the entire game. You wouldn't think that this room would be all that big of a deal, but having two greeds on top of having to dodge Fistula breaking up all over the place, it's a little bit harrowing. Well, I mean, look, we're probably going to end up not going in the right direction here, so I'm just going to fight the Envy fight. It's not that big of a deal with 2020, and especially with the Parasite helping out as well. Just annoying. It's not that this room is hard, it's just tedious. Now, it can be difficult if you don't have good damage. This could be a run-ending room right here. I always recommend bombing your way out of this room if you know that you're going in the right direction. Unless you just need the full charge or something. Or if you just feel like killing Envy, let alone 5 of them. You can do that too. And eventually we'll get to the point where there's no more Envy. I'm envious of the time when we don't have to be in this room anymore. I'm really hoping that the chest will give us some more HP. That's really the only thing that's going to stop us at this point, is going to be HP. Damage, we don't need to get any more damage upgrades, especially with the Curved Horn, to win the game. We're solid on that. But HP is a little bit of a worry for me. Our defense is not that great. In fact, it's non-existent. The only defense we have is our HP. There's Monster 2. It's waiting for you, buddy. Okay, so the parasite plus the chocolate milk shot blocked my view of that projectile from that fly, which is a little bit lame. Don't ever shoot Ibukakami again. Alright, so we have a cherry card, and the hangman is not exactly a top tier card that we're looking for right now. Gertie Jr., I think everyone knows how I feel about Gertie Jr. at this point, especially after yesterday's run. Lucky Toe. Lucky Toe, thank you, no. Take more keys, absolutely. It's nice to be able to go into a room and just burst down. Okay, let's dial it back here. Stop talking, start playing. It's nice to be able to go into a room and burst down the first thing that you see with the charge shot of chalk and milk. It's like Brimstone in a little bit of that sense. Really, we're not getting any red hearts. I'd love to, but I can't. And we're in that position again where this happened yesterday. Where everything was solid and it only took one time. Really, it only took one bad room to end the run. And that's usually how it goes anyway, but yeah. We are not going to be able to fight Isaac with only three hearts and no orbital. The chariot card might be a big time play here. Thank goodness for that. Alright, now we feel a little bit better. Alright, so between the chariot card and our damage, I'm hoping that that's going to be enough to get us to the chest. If we can get to the chest, I think we will win. Well, I don't think it's not guaranteed, obviously, but I think that we have it in us to win. Need to get him out of this phase as fast as possible. There we go. Alright, so this is... should be game over here, and if I'm able to save the chariot card, that'd be even better. A massive amount of damage to that fully charged shot of chocolate milk. Unfortunately, I keep attacking Isaac at the wrong angle. Almost got caught by Crack the Sky there. That would have been a little bit sloppy. Okay, so we made it through without getting a hit. And I'm okay with that. We've got our Degas rune here, just in case if there is a Curse of the Blind. There's not. Let's see what we got. Mitre. Dry Baby, Fat Odd Mushroom, and Spelunker Salmon. I'll absolutely take Fat Odd Mushroom. We'll reroll everything else. Obviously, the Mitre is not going to help us for this particular run. Spelunker's Helm, Dry Baby, or... don't really need it. Fat Odd Mushroom, of course, is great because it gives you an HP, plus it gives you a damage upgrade. Not the biggest of damage upgrades, but still pretty good. I'm more interested in it for its HP right now, obviously. The more red hearts we get, the better. I'm not able to speak today, apparently. Yeah, it's not a very good item. I didn't see that shot because of chocolate milk. So, we really cannot afford to be taking hits here and there. I would love to fill up our heart containers via Sun Card, via Lard, via really anything. Anything that will heal us, I'm all for it. Gertie Sr. is not going to be able to put up much of a fight. Alright, so let's go use our reroll in the chest room. And yes, sir, indeed. Will I take both damage multipliers in the game? Absolutely. I might as well take the leech as well. Alright, so we got Magic Mush. Oh, man. Magic Mush Eve's eyeshadow is so much damage because they multiply each other. I picked up the leech just in case if we need the emergency red heal, red heart heal, but at this point, I think it's safe to say that we have got ourselves a one run here. The amount of damage that Eve's eyeshadow plus Magic Mush plus Chalk and Milk does is ridiculous. Yeah, we one shot the haunt right there. Feeling pretty good about our situation now, obviously. Two shot Dark One. One shot Super Sloth. Oh man, it's beautiful. The range is actually pretty good as well. Full card. I mean, might as well use the Degas Ring just to get out of here. Hold on to the Chariot card, but combined with the Chariot card, I think that it's now impossible for us to lose this run with our damage. And that's exactly what I was hoping would happen, is that we just come in here. Where did we get the Soul Heart from? Did the Degas Ring give us that? It must have. Should have killed Gluttony last there. Honestly, I wasn't even thinking because I just wanted to see how big the Sears could get. Here roll the quarter, and we got Halo Flies, which is also fantastic. We needed to shore up our defenses there. And having two orbitals out of nowhere is definitely the way to do it. So we are going to be able to get a win here on the No Soul Heart Challenge, and I feel good about that. Really, really solid run overall. We didn't get a single deal with the Devil. We didn't get a single deal with the Angel. We did accidentally pick up two Soul Hearts via the Super Bandage and via, I believe it was the Degas Rune, but obviously I got rid of those immediately. So, like, I don't feel guilty about anything I've done in this run. Overall, a very solid run, and we get at least another challenge run down out of the way, and I am happy for it. Thank you, everyone, for giving me your ideas for the challenge runs. Hope you've all been enjoying it. Stay tuned. What will the next challenge be? Only I will know, and only you will find out tomorrow here on the channel. Until then, so long, everybody.